Hello friends, so today we will continue our discussion about crystal imperfections, or it is also called as crystal defects. So we discuss about the point defects, and the point defects becomes vacancy and substitutional and interstitial type of defects. And now we see the next type of crystal defects, that is line defect. So line defects are of two types, that is edge dislocation and screw dislocation. Okay, so in case of this line defects, it is also called as one dimensional defect. Why it is called as one dimensional defect? Because if we want to represent the line by using XY coordinate system or XYZ coordinate system, then it requires only one distance. Okay, so it is called as one dimensional. Now we start with the first type of line defect, that is edge dislocation. So we consider this is one of the lattice pattern, and at the lattice location we draw the atoms. Okay, at each lattice point we draw the atoms or molecules or ions. Okay, in this case consider this other atoms. Now this is uniform structure, this pattern is uniform pattern, and if we insert half plane of atoms in between this structure, then what happens? compare both the diagrams. If we consider this diagram having uniform atoms, pattern is uniform. If we see here, this is the extra plane which is having the number of atoms, and this plane becomes half plane. We are not taking complete line, okay, we are not taking complete atoms in this plane, we are taking only half portion. So what happens due to this half portion? So here, if we see, a lot of strain occurs on this in between the bond, in between the atoms. Okay, in this bond, bonds are present. Okay, every atom is connected with bond. So at this region, lot of strain occurs on these atoms and on these bonds. Okay, lot of strain occurs in this region. So this is actually a regular pattern, but in this region, lot of strain occurs on this bond. Okay, and this is represented with this inverted T letter or the perpendicular symbol. This is perpendicular symbol. Okay, now what happens here? Actually, this each dislocation concept is correlated with one of the real life example, that is caterpillar. Okay, if we take the example of caterpillar, so how that caterpillar moves from one place to another place. Okay, it is not moves like straight. Okay, like straight, it is not move like straight, but that caterpillar, this caterpillar moves like this. Okay, first start, then like this, then first straight. Okay, again straight. So move like this, then again curve like this, and again move like this. So like this. This type of movement is there here. So this type of movement is there. Okay. Why this caterpillar moves like this? Because to avoid the more contact on that ground. If contact is more, then more amount of energy is required to move in front direction. Okay. So it contacts minimum. And in this way, it saves the energy. It saves the energy. Now, what happens? Now, what happens in this case? Okay. So, if we consider this first diagram, and now if we consider this is a plane. If we consider this is the separate plane, and now if this complete or this upper region, this is called as upper region, this is called as lower region. So this upper region, if moves in front direction, upper region moves in front direction, and lower region remains like in its place. Okay, so like shearing, if we consider the example of shearing, what happens in that shearing? That is one plane and this is another plane. So one plane and another plane move at different direction, or one plane remains as it is and another plane moves like this. Okay, slight movement takes place. If we consider this upper region slightly moves towards the right direction. So after moving this, okay, after moving this, our diagram is like this. Okay, so So along this plane, the separation takes place. Now, how much energy it needed to move in this direction, this upper region, to move in front direction or this region? Okay. So if we observe here at first diagram and this diagram, all atoms are connected with bonds. And if we imagine, if we break, or if we want to change, break this bond, then it requires some energy for single atom. Okay, if we consider these two atoms, and if we want to break this bond, okay, it requires some amount of energy. But if we want to move complete structure on the right side, so imagine how many bonds are there. Okay, so all these bonds, after breaking, then only this upper region moves towards the towards this direction. Okay, so it is needed to break all these bonds, then only it is possible to move this object, or to move this structure on this direction. Okay, it is needed to break all these bonds. Okay, so imagine, for each bond some energy is required, and if we want to move this complete part on this direction, so we needed all these bonds to break, then only it is possible to move in this direction. So how it happens? Actually, it needed theoretically it needed lot of energy. Theoretically, it is needed lot of energy to break this bond, but in actual, when it happens, it requires small amount of energy. It requires small amount of energy. This invention takes place in the year of 1900. In this year, it is invented that the actual, theoretically, it requires more amount of energy, but actually, it moves with less amount of energy. It moves with less amount of energy. So why it happens? This is the question which is came in the mind of researchers. Why it happens? The answer is that there should be some defects in that material, and that is the reason why it requires less amount of energy to move like this. Okay, so there should be some material defects, and due to that material defects, it is easily move, or this structure is easy, upper region structure is easily moved towards the right direction. It is possible. Okay, so this is due to the line defect. So what happened there? So it is not take complete structure, or it is not take this complete atoms at the same time, but it takes one by one. Okay, so first this is break, then it is connected to another, then next bond is break and connected to another, next bond is break, another. Okay, in this way, now this is again, this bond breaks and it is connected like here. Okay, then only it is shifted like that. Okay, so in this way, it is not directly shifted, but it cuts one by one and it is moving towards the front direction. So in this way, this type of line defects happens, and this is called as edge dislocation. This edge dislocation is represented with Berger's vector. The scientist named as Berger, who invented this, so it is named as Berger's vector. So Berger's vector gives us at which direction we or this that defect gets happen, okay, or how much distance we move. Okay, so if we see what is the Berger's vector, see this diagram. observe this. Okay, so this is actually one plane which is inserted in half region. Now consider take this extra one. Okay, if we compare both this diagram, so it requires more amount of distance to cover to this defect, and it requires less amount of distance to move to cover this. If the structure is regular structure, it is not required large amount of distance to move. Okay, so this much extra distance it is required to move in this type of defects. Okay, this is actually edge dislocation. Here plane is not present, so this plane, due to this plane defect happens, and this is line defect, and here it requires more amount of distance covered. Okay, while completing this region, and it is required less amount of distance required to cover this region, same region. So this much amount of maximum distance it required to cover more in this case. Okay, so this is called as Burgers vector. This distance is called as Burgers vector. Okay, now this arrow and this distance represent the direction, at which direction the defect is happening. Okay, and this much distance or this much amount of defect present here, so it is called as edge dislocation. Okay. So if we observe here, this is A, B, C, and this is D. Okay. So if we compare now, if we consider the second type of line defect, that is screw dislocation. Why it is called as screw dislocation? Because this movement is like a screw. When we rotate the screw, so how that motion takes place? So similar type of arrangement is also there in between that material structure. Okay. So consider this screw, and this becomes the threads. Now, if we move from here, so it comes at front location, then it again goes to back side, and then it again comes to front side. So front side, back side, front side. So this type of motion present inside this structure, and this is actually three dimensional. This is three dimensional. So inside this, this type of motion takes place. So here we represent with two different diagrams. This is actually front view, and if we consider the side view, then sorry, if we consider the top view, if we cut this, if we observe the top view, then we see this type of structure. Okay, so here observe that the screw, when we rotate the screw, this type of motion takes place in between this plane. So this is location A. In on the back side of this C, location B is present. Then this is location C, this is location D. Okay, so if we observe here, this is A, B, C, D, and this region, okay, here intentionally open circles are shown, and here the dot becomes closed circles. Okay, so in this region, this type of screw-like dislocation takes place. Okay, and so it is called as screw dislocation. Now, what is the role of Berger vector in this case? So Berger vector is parallel in this case. If we compare this Berger vector in case of edge dislocation, in case of edge dislocation, Berger's vector becomes perpendicular. In case of this screw dislocation, this Berger vector becomes parallel. Okay, this is the only difference. And in each dislocation, half plane is available, half plane of atoms are available, and another half is not available. Okay, and due to that, lot of strain created at that region. Okay, and in this case, the motion becomes the screw movement. Okay, screw movement, and in this way, this completely atom gets turned out. Complete atom gets turned out. And it is shifted in this direction. For example, this distance is called as phase distance. We all of you know that distance between two corresponding threads are called as phase distance. Now, if we turn this for one rotation, then it is moved in actual direction with this phase distance. Similarly, if we consider this crystal structure or these atoms, then the motion takes place at the inner side, and after the motion, how much distance is it moves? It moves this much distance. Okay, after one rotation, it moves the distance similar to this pitch distance. So this much distance it moves on the another direction. So this is called as screw dislocation. Why this dislocation or why this defect study is important? Why this defect study is important? Because property of material is mostly depend on this type of defects only. Okay, strength of the material also depends on the defects. Okay, so this study of defects are very important. If defects are more, then material is more ductile. If defects in material are less, then material becomes non-ductile, that material becomes brittle material. This is the major difference. Okay, if we consider the next type of defect, that defect is called as planar defect. Next type of defect is called as planar defect, or this is present at the grain boundary. Okay, so if we consider the structure of that material, then in that structure this type of atoms are arranged. Okay, this type of atoms are arranged, and in some regions the if we consider like this. This is the material. Uniform structure is there, but in some way overlapping is there. Okay, like this type of boundaries are created in that material. This type of boundaries are created due to the overlapping of one plane on the another plane. Why this overlapping happens? Okay. Now, if we consider, these are the atoms. Okay. This is one region, this is another region, and now if we do the some process on that material, then all these atoms come close to each other. Now this gap is present, and after if we press these two parts together, or if we want to close these two atoms, or if we want to bring